Hello friends, welcome back to the OpenCV playlist. In this session, we will understand clearly the bitwise operations with the images. What do you mean by that? Very simple. We are going to understand how we are going to do bitwise ANDing, bitwise OR, bitwise XOR and bitwise NOT. All these operations are going to be demonstrated practically to you right now with inputs and results. Stay tuned and you will definitely like it. First, we will start with the AND, I mean bitwise ANDing. What do we do there first? We will have to go ahead and do the formalities in the beginning. Yes, I need to import CV2. I'm importing NumPy as NP and that is traditional. Let me do it regularly. Now, I'm reading the first image 1.jpg. I'm reading the second image 2.jpg. The 1.jpg is the first of white and the second of black. And 2.jpg is a complete black with a white circle inside. Why we keep it this way is when you do a bitwise ANDing, you can see the changes very clearly. How do we do the bitwise ANDing? Very simple. CV2 dot bitwise underscore AND image 1 and image 2 with masks equal to none. You can see that 1.jpg and 2.jpg are represented as image 1 and image 2. And we are going to show the final result, the ANDed image right now. Wait key is used as usual. And let's see if we can run this code to see the output clearly. Let me display the contents to see where is my file. Yes, 5 underscore file is there. Image underscore and .py. And the results are obtained right now. And you can see that the input images are clearly available right in front of you. When I do an AND, you can see that the circle is cut into half and you can see the result right here in front of you. And this is how the bitwise ANDing will work on images. This is bitwise ANDing. I'm showing you the image once again for you to understand what exactly were the inputs. Can we go to the next one? Yes, it's time for us to understand the next one. The next one is bitwise OR. Rest of the things remain the same. We are going to do the initialization. I'll read the image 1 and image 2. Image 1 and image 2 remain the same. I'm going to use CV2 dot bitwise underscore R, image 1, image 2 and masks equal to none. That's all. I store this result in ARD image and I'm displaying the ARD image as the final CV2.im show content. That's it. It will work and it should work. Let's run it to see how exactly it works. The ARD result is present here and let's see how exactly the input images are available here. The first half is white, the second half is black and the complete content is black and in between it was white. So when I do a digital ORing, I mean bitwise ORing, you get this result and it's clearly visible in front of you right now for you to understand the functionality. Can we go to the next one? Yes, OR, XOR. How do we do XOR? The rest of the content remain the same. I read the image 1, I read the image 2 with IM read, and then the method that I'm going to use is CV2 dot bitwise underscore XR with image 1 and image 2 as arguments and masks equal to none as the parameter. Now I'm going to display it right now to see how exactly it works after the execution. Let's first execute it and this is the XR result. You will see the input image once again for us to have a clarity so that you will understand it clearly. You can see that it's perfectly available right now and 1.jpg is available, 2.jpg is available. The XOR result is also presented to you for your easier and clearer understanding. The final one is NOT and nothing but the bitwise NOT, which is nothing but the inversion operation. If I have 1, it will become 0. If I have 0, it will become 1. So I have taken the image 1 and I'm going to do CV2 dot bitwise underscore NOT. When I do this, I collect the result in NOT image and I am displaying it. That's it. It's very simple and we will see how exactly we could run it. ./8 bitwise NOT. You can see that the input image has the first of white and the second of black. I'm going to open it right now for you. It's all available this way. First of white and second of black. But the output image is exactly inverted and you could see that here the input and output one after another. That's it. We have inverted the image and this is how the bitwise operations can be done with OpenCV and I hope you understood this clearly. If you like the content, please subscribe and if you have any queries, suggestions, please go ahead and type it in the comment section. If you like the channel, please refer to your friends as well. Thank you.